And hello, everybody. Welcome to Carolina & Company Live. It's so glad to have you here today. We've got a lot of interesting things on the show that you're going to learn something today. And if you tell a friend, they will learn something too. But first off, before we get underway, let's find out what's happening in the weather.
Yes, Cecil, temperatures right now are currently in the 30s throughout the region. 37 in Darlington, 39 Florence, 39 in Sumter, down in Manning as well. 45 finally being recorded there in King Street, 40 in North Myrtle, 41 in Georgetown. But the wind chills continue over in Darlington, a place that was 11 degrees this morning, 32 now. So at least they've warmed up some, but still at that freezing mark. Feels like 29 in Laurinburg, 38 in King Street. And a location reaching the 40s there along the Grand Strand, but it's feeling more like the mid-30s. Our dew points continue to be rather low across the region, with many locations dealing with single digits. If you're like me, you may be shocking yourself because of that. Of course, unnecessarily shocking yourself. You're not purposefully doing it. Just a lot of static electricity in the air, all due to this dry air, which is moving through the Carolinas today. But notice this shield of water vapor. More moist conditions, I should say, headed towards the Carolinas, and that ahead of our next storm system. Right now, we're still under the influence of a pretty large and potent high-pressure system. Currently over Pennsylvania. That's a northeast wind for us today. Yesterday, a due north wind traveled directly over the snowpack, and that allowed us to get straight cold air. Today, that wind coming over the waters, and the waters are still warm, believe it or not. Maybe cold for you and me, but warmer than land. And that actually modifies the air mass, allowing us to reach into the 40s today, even though the wind will continue to keep a wind chill in the upper 30s. I do believe we will reach a wind chill of 40 degrees, which is still a little warmer inland. 38 there for your wind chill at 2 o'clock, 40 degrees for the wind chill at 4 p.m. despite an actual temperature of 44. For Grand Strand locations, again, very similar, 44 degrees there by 4 p.m. But again, the wind making it feel more like 38 at the beaches. Again, remember yesterday the beaches struggled to even reach freezing for their wind chill throughout the day. So at least it's a little warmer. Plenty of sunny skies today before we begin to see some weekend systems begin to roll in. Our first one actually comes tomorrow. Few isolated showers in the morning, but we are plenty warm. So any of this moisture that does traverse through the area tomorrow will fall in the way of rain. But look at these temperatures, 60s, maybe a 70 degree reading. I think that may be a hair too high, but still, it's better than what we're at now. So expect that 20 degree rise between today and tomorrow. 20% chance of an isolated shower. Again, the clouds will be the big story tomorrow. Rainfall Wednesday night into our Thursday morning commute. Thursday morning looking very messy, but Thursday evening, plenty of sunny skies on your way home from work or errands or school. Sunny skies continue Friday, mostly sunny and partly cloudy through the weekend.
All right, we've got a great show lined up today, a lot of fun stuff. But before we get underway, we've got to talk a little bit about today. And today is Tuesday, January 22nd. And this is Come In From The Cold Day. Well, that's a perfect thing for this. And it's also Celebration of Life Day. All right, let's go back to 1949. Steve Perry, he's 70 years old. He's the lead singer for Journey from 1978 to 1987. Platinum album, Trial by Fire. And at 12, he heard Sam Cooke sing Cupid, and that inspired him to be a singer. How about that? 1955, John Wesley Shipp, 64 years old, soap opera, The Guiding Light from 1980 to 1984, and the Flash TV series on CBS from 1990 to 91. And he was also in Dawson Creek series. 1959, Linda Blair, 60 years old. You remember The Exorcist, where her head spins around? Of course you do. And also, she was in Exorcist 2. Now, before fame, she was a child model at age 6. All right, today in history, let's check it out. 1943, the world record. Listen up, Zach. The world record for the fastest temperature change took place in Spearfish, South Dakota.
Whoa!
Listen, now, it went from 4 degrees to 45 degrees in 2 minutes.
No way!
Can you believe it?
I can't!
Oh, man! All right, 1946, creation of the Central Intelligence Group and the forerunner of the Central Intelligence Agency. In other words, the CIA, and still today, nobody knows who they are or what they do. All right, from Know-It-All Department, here we go. You learn something every day, and this is from 2009 now. This is a funny one. Listen to this. A man on trial in San Diego brought a bag of poop into the courtroom. He smeared it on the face of his lawyer and then threw the remainder of the poop at the jury. Guess what? He was charged with robbery and 2 counts of assault with poop and was sentenced to 31 years in jail. So the object of that is not carry poop with you when you're on trial. That's it from the Know-It-All Department today, where you learn something every day. We got a great show lined up, some fun stuff. Stay with us. First, the pet of the day is coming up. She's on green mic. And welcome back. Every Tuesday, Grand Strand Humane Society is here with Pet of the Day. And Kathy's here. And Kathy, who do you have?
Oh, this is Colby.
Colby.
Colby, isn't she beautiful?
She is
so beautiful. She's around 10 years old.
Uh-huh.
I don't know what she is, but I'm going to guess maybe like a shepherd, maybe a cattle dog mix. But yeah, I just have a hard time believing that she's 10 years old. She has so much energy. We have a new playground now at the shelter, a huge playground. And she has so much fun there. She just runs and plays and jumps. And she does have kind of like a herding instinct, which makes me think she might have some cattle dog or some maybe border collie in her or something like that. But she was an owner surrender. The people they got a puppy, and Colby wasn't too happy with the puppy. So they got rid of Colby. So after 10 years.
That happens a lot of times.
It is very, very sad. But
Colby, we're going to get you some new parents to take care of you.
Right. Look at
that face.
You. She is such a good girl.
Okay, now what's going on? Is Colby ready for adoption?
She is definitely ready for adoption.
Everything's ready.
Ready. We had a really good adoption weekend. We had our fee waived adoption event over the weekend. We had 46 adoptions, dogs and cats.
Wow.
Yeah, we had 27. Let me see if I get this right. 27 cats and 19 dogs. So that was really good. We had that was very important because now we have to move all our dogs inside because of all the cold weather and everything.
Oh, they gave you a little more room and
that's
everything.
That's right. Gives us more room because we'll always fill up again really quickly. But yeah, we had a really good number.
Now, what's coming up? Anything coming up this weekend?
We have PetSmart this coming weekend, Saturday and Sunday on 544 and 17.
Now, what do y'all do at PetSmart? Tell them what you do.
We set up a little booth there and we bring our adoptable dogs. And we talk to people about how wonderful they are and what we do. And we try to get volunteers and fosters and hopefully adoptions. And we just have a good time. The dogs get out. They get to walk around PetSmart and pick out the toys that they want to play with and things like that. So it's good. It's a fun thing to do.
All right. Now, the success of getting these pets adopted when you bring them on the show, has it been all but one so far?
There's only just one so far.
One so far?
Yeah, her name is Eve. We're waiting for Eve to go home, but everybody else has gone home except Eve.
Well, that's still amazing.
And now we have to worry about Colby. Colby's got to go.
That's still amazing, though. You've got to think about it.
Mm-hmm.
All the dogs, and somebody comes on there watching the show.
That's right.
And they see the pet, and they want them.
That's right.
That is so good.
All right,
your hours, tell them when you're open.
We're open 12 to 5, 7 days a week, but we have extended hours Thursday and Friday to 7 o'clock. So 7 days a week, and so there's no excuse not to come by.
Donations, you can take money, what else? Food?
Food, blankets, of course, towels, detergent, bleach, paper towels, big plastic bags, garbage bags, and things like that. And we're always looking for volunteers, people to walk dogs and take care of cats and do dishes and clean the shelter or whatever they feel like doing.
All you got to do is contact the shelter, and they'll tell you what they can use you to do.
We have lots of nice dogs.
And I think
like
that's great. Y'all got a big playground now.
It's wonderful. What a wonderful thing to happen for us. We're so happy with it.
We appreciate you.
Thank you very much.
All right. More coming up. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Roma, and The Favorite led the pack with 10 nominations.
Future Tech is here today. See what tech will trend this year after our advertiser. Check out the upcoming fun and cool tech trends that I found at CES. These amazing flexible screens are new technology. Put it on purses, hats, and tablets that bend. No more broken screens. We have virtual reality, augmented reality, and now mixed reality, which blends virtual objects with the real world. For example, a virtual cat can jump on a real table. And you might find Alexa in the shape of a person rather than a device on your counter.
In Las Vegas, Nevada, it's 59 degrees Fahrenheit with mostly sunny skies.
And retro styling is in, from arcade games to Bluetooth speakers and record players. It'll be a fun year in tech. I'm Francie Black. For more great tips, visit TechTangoToday.com.
The world of high tech, that's what it's all turning to right now. All right, we're going to talk about the 21st annual Super Bowl. That's right, soup. You know what I'm talking about. It's set for Saturday, January 26th at Precious Blood Catholic Church in Pawleys Island. And they got a lot of restaurants and everything. The proceeds from this going to Habitat for Humanity. All right, we got Christine and Laurel.
Morning.
Yes.
How y'all doing? Christine, talk a little bit about this deal.
Great. Oh, we are so excited. Number one, if you saw the weather forecast, you know that the temperature is going to be absolutely perfect for soup. This event, as you said, is our 24th annual Super Bowl. It's held at Precious Blood of Christ Family Life Center at Pawleys Island. You walk in, present your ticket, you buy a ticket, buy beverage tickets, and then when the doors open, you run to the back and pick out a gorgeous bowl that has been handmade, hand-painted by some of our artists.
Right, and so and you get the bowl, when you buy that, you get the soup.
Yes, it's a package deal.
Yeah,
and then on both sides of the building, we have soups lined up. And right now we have 39 soups.
39?
39, yes.
A lot of restaurants and just different
Absolutely.
People making soup?
Absolutely. Restaurants.
Oh,
all
restaurants.
Yeah,
great.
Throughout the county.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's great.
Yeah. And so you go through and you sip on soups, and we have bread available that you can dip your soup. And then around 7 o'clock, we open up soup to go. so you can take home a quarts of your favorite soups.
Well, that's good. Yeah. That is good. All right, Laura, what else we got to need to talk about?
Well, there's also the silent auction.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
tell
there
us about
is.
That.
We
tell
do
me
have
that.
A silent auction.
Okay.
We have hammocks. We have pillows.
We have beautiful painted from their local artists painted pictures.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm.
There is just a variety of things, and we kind of put them in groupings,
so
you can bid on a whole little package.
So everybody can have a little soup, walk through, and make a bid, and
absolutely
do that. What kind
absolutely
of money are we talking about raising here for the Habitat?
Well, in the past years, we're looking at netting anywhere from $15,000 to $20,000.
That is very good. And this goes to a great cause.
It does. It does. And of course, we could not do this without our volunteers.
That's right.
Right now, we have probably 110 volunteers that will touch this event.
Well, that is great. All right, it's coming up January 26th, starts at 5:30, right?
5:30, yes.
You be there, get you some soup, and then you can buy leftovers to take home for supper.
That's right. That's
all right, Christine, Laura, thank y'all both for being with us.
Thank you.
All right. All right, now, if you know that today they unveiled Oscars. That's right. Who's going to be a winner? Well, let's find out. ABC's Chris Connolly has a report on the Oscars coming up.
Roma and The Favorite led the pack with 10 nominations each, including Best Picture.
If you forget to load the pellet, the gun fires, makes a sound, but releases no shot.
The Favorite also taking home 3 major acting nods. Best Actress for Olivia Colman.
Look at me! Look at me! How dare you! Close your eyes!
And Best Supporting Actress for both Emma Stone and Rachel Weisz.
No one but me would dare, and I did not.
But don't count out Black Panther.
The world took everything away from me! Everything I ever loved!
The $700 million blockbuster becoming the first superhero movie to be nominated for Best Picture. Black Panther will be fighting it out against The Star Is Born, which scored nods for Best Picture. Lead actor for Bradley Cooper.
Maybe it's time to let the old ways down.
Lead actress Lady Gaga.
Aren't you tired trying to fill that void?
As well as original song for Shallow. The Queen biopic, Bohemian Rhapsody, also nominated for Best Picture as well, and for Lead Actor for Rami Malek. Other films up for Best Picture include Black Klansman, which also saw Spike Lee pick up his first ever Best Director nomination. Green Book, which received nods in both the lead and supporting actor categories for Viggo Mortensen and Mahershala Ali. And Vice, which was also recognized for lead actor for Christian Bale. Amy Adams for Best Actress in a Supporting Role. Best Director for Adam McKay. Disney's The Incredibles 2 and Ralph Breaks the Internet both nabbed a nod in the Best Animated Feature category. And there were a few surprises this morning, too. Bradley Cooper missing out on a directing nod for A Star Is Born. And Emily Blunt denied nominations for both of her roles in Mary Poppins Returns and A Quiet Place.
Okay, the Florence Little Theater, known for a lot of productions over there. Well, they're getting ready for one starting this weekend. Now, we're talking about the Little Shop of Horrors. That's been around for a long time. And this is going to be a pretty wild deal. You know, this is where a floral assistant stumbles across a new breed of plant. It's pretty wild. But we're going to find out from Jessica now a little bit more about the Little Shop of Horrors.
Thank you, Cecil. Well, you're right. This meek little floral assistant finds this new plant and grooms this plant, and it becomes a bloodthirsty plant and ends up eating some of the people involved.
Wow.
The plant itself we rented from a company in New York.
Oh, really?
It's beautiful. I didn't want to ruin any surprises with pictures of the plant.
Of course.
But it is gorgeous, and our friends at Florence Regional Arts Alliance helped us get that. So we are very excited. The cast features some new faces and some veteran faces. The voice of the plant is done by Ray Taylor, who is a beautiful bass singer. So
got a deep voice.
Deep voice.
Well, that's good. How big's your staff on this one, you know, the cast?
It's a cast of about 25, and then the crew is about 25 or 30.
Wow.
It takes more crew than it does actors.
All right, now you're talking about some new faces this time. Mm-hmm. You know, what if somebody wanted to get in, you know, into the little theater? How can they do that?
Well, we have open auditions all season long. We post those on our Facebook page and on our website. And anyone is welcome to audition. There are age restrictions depending on the show, but we're open to everyone to audition.
All right, now you got something coming up, but let me make sure I'm right here. The 25th through the 3rd, right?
That's right.
Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Goldilocks and the Three Bears will be the next weekend, February 9th, and that is a 35-minute show. It's great for young audiences, ages really 2 to 10 or so. It's perfect for them.
So bring the kids for this.
Bring the kids. It's only $5.
That's unbelievable. Now, how many do you have playing that? You got Goldilocks and Three Bears at least. You got four
you have
people.
Mama Bear, Papa Bear, Baby Bear.
So that's pretty good. So the kids will enjoy that.
Yes, they will.
All right, there's always something going on. If you want to find out more about it, you can go to that website right there.
That's right.
And find out about the Florence Little Theater and things that are happening. All right, how long have you been with the theater now?
I've been with the theater about 5 years now.
5 years?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, your new facility. I have not been in there, but it looks amazing from the outside.
Well, you have to come, and surprisingly, it's 10 years old now.
I know it.
And we have already almost outgrown it.
Really? How many people do you seat?
We seat 394.
And y'all fill it up a lot.
We do. We do.
Well, you're doing a great job on that. All right, Little Shop of Horrors. I've heard this and seen this in a lot of productions all over, but this is going to be neat. Now, the plant itself, how big is the plant?
The plant at its biggest is about 8 feet tall.
8 feet
and
tall.
5 feet wide.
Wow.
And then there's the small one that's handheld.
Right.
It evolves over the show.
So 8 feet tall. All right. Now, is this open? This open to kids for this show, or you don't recommend
it? It's recommended 12 and up. There is a little bit of language in adult situations.
Okay, we can do that. All right. Now, what's the rest of the season look like? What you got coming up later on?
In March, we have Dixie Swim Club, and in April and May, we have Mamma Mia.
Mamma Mia!
Yes.
Wow.
Highly anticipated.
In Conway at the Republic Theater. They did a great job on it, too. So Mamma Mia's coming. You got to send me an email where I can get you on. We can come back for that.
I'll do it.
That's a great show. I've seen them both now. And let me tell you, it's not a chick flick. I just want them to know that.
That's right.
I really enjoyed it.
Good.
Well, you see a former James Bond singing. What do you see that much in that actual movie?
That's right.
Thank you so much, Jessica. We appreciate it. All right, Florence Little Theater, you want to know more about it, go to the website and you can find out everything that's happening there, all the events that are coming up. And coming up this weekend, we're talking about Shop of Horrors. And then the following weekend, Goldilocks and the Three Bears, all kinds of entertainment right there in Florence. All right, we'll be back. Stay with us.
It's funny, it's crazy, and you never know what Cecil or Amanda are going to say or do. It's Carolina and Company live weekdays on ABC 15, a fun show that makes you laugh and makes you feel good about where you live. If you just moved to the area, Carolina and Company live is the show you need to watch. You'll find out about everything going on along the Grand Strand, Beatty, and Border Belt. Check it out weekdays at noon on WBDE ABC 15.
right, we had a great time today. Now, don't forget, tomorrow, a special show. What happens? How do things go together at a television station? We're going to show you how we get paid, behind the scenes, and what all and people do. All that's coming up tomorrow on a special show. We've had a great time today. And the special show tomorrow, hey, we'll see you. You'll learn something if you watch. Tell a friend about the show, and they'll watch and learn something every day. Thank you so much for joining us. We have a great time. Thank you so much.
Carolina & Company Live is sponsored by the businesses, organizations, and groups featured in this program. The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect that of WPDE ABC 15, WWMB CW 21, or its employees.
It's funny, it's crazy, and you never know what Cecil or Amanda are going to say or do.
Hollywood!
It's Carolina & Company live weekdays on ABC 15, a fun show that makes you laugh and makes you feel good about where you live.